Hi, good day everybody. It is not the morning. This time we're getting a little bit of a late start. It's actually about 3:30 in the afternoon. The reason we're getting off to a late start is because we have a big evening planned. In a few hours, I'm going to be heading with my family over to the Araneta Coliseum, Alaska-Ginebra. They're having a tribute for me at halftime, and we're not even at the arena yet, and I'm a little blown away. I put up my blog post yesterday evening, and since then, my social media has just gone crazy, and I didn't know if there was going to be this kind of response. Every time I look down on my Twitter, it says 20 plus notifications. All these great things are coming out. Former teammates, Don Hondaveros, Jeff Carriasso, Danny Siegel have been writing great things. Other guys have been writing great things on Instagram and Twitter. People I haven't heard from in a long time have been hitting me up on Facebook. And former coaches, John Uchico Chotreyes. It's really been an overwhelming response. I'm having a tough time keeping it together here in our living room. I wonder what it's going to be like at Araneta tonight. So I got to start getting ready and getting myself mentally. I didn't realize this was going to be this big. I'm not quite sure what to expect at the game tonight, but we're bringing the camera, bringing you guys along with us. Enjoy. Here at the Araneta Coliseum, already seeing some familiar faces and some fans, ready to go inside with my son. The first time I'm entering Araneta with my son, so I'm pumped up about this. All right, this is gonna be crazy. Let's go, Sebastian. Let's go. Okay, so we're about halfway through the second quarter. I have this halftime thing. I'm a little nervous. Don't quite have my speech ready yet, but I'm sure I'll get through it. It's a lot of thank yous. Video should be interesting, and I see some friends are actually here that I weren't expecting to be here, so it's been cool. 6 more minutes.
and 2005 MVP. And Charles Boyd, number 30, Major Pay, Eric Gabi, Kamusta Kayong Lahat. Thank you so much. A lot of people to thank. You know, the first thing I want to say is I was just very blessed to play in the PBA for as long as I have, and for the team, the teams, and the people that I played with and I played for. I am very, very thankful for, and I just want to say thank you. It's great to see. I want to thank Alaska for putting this thing together. It's good to see all the Ginebra fans. You know, I hadn't played for them for 5 years, but the response that I've gotten the last few days from many of their fans, also from former teammates and former coaches, has been overwhelming. And all I can say is thank you. It's been a dream come true to play as long as I have and play in front of you guys. So thank you very much. Maraming salamat.
Okay, well, that was unique. Had to give a little speech, kicked a little Tagalog. It went well. It was nice. A few surprises. Parents were in the video. Rudy Hatfield were in the video. Was in the video. So I didn't expect to see those guys. I'm very thankful for Alaska to go into those lengths to get an interview from those people. And also, some of my best friends were there. Harvey Carey, Jimmy Alapag, Danny Siegel. Alaska was in support. Mark and JJ came out to support. Bobby Jose, one of the guys I mentioned in my blog post, one of my old teammates, was there. Haven't seen him in a while. So it was great. It was unbelievable, overwhelming experience. The experience leading into coming here was crazy. Very thankful. Hanging out in the lounge now. Imagine that. And thanks, guys.
So that was it. That was a nice, a great ceremony. I know a lot of basketball players, they don't get that type of retirement type send-off. So I feel very blessed and very thankful. I just want to say one more big thank you, in particular to the Alaska Aces organization. They're the ones that really put that together. If you noticed in the tribute video, there was a lot of highlights of me at Tandawai, me at Ginebra, a competitor of theirs in the PBA that I'm sure that they don't really like. So it was really nice of them. You won't see franchises do that. It was really nice of them to put that together and honor my entire career, even though I was only with their organization for 2 years. So I'm very thankful to them. I'm thankful to TV and Sports 5 for really pushing, really putting it out there. They advertised it, they really built it up. So without the TV 5 and Sports 5 marketing to get behind it, to really give the awareness to the fans. And, you know, I'd like to thank them too, because all of the messages that I got, the feedback that I received was tremendous. I didn't expect that type of response. So everyone out there that's responded on Twitter, Instagram, Facebook, even YouTube, you YouTubers out there have been just unbelievably positive. So it was a big day for me, a big day for my family. I'm so thankful that I had a last day like that. I'd also like to thank the PBA. You know, when the commissioner handed over my plaque with the jersey on it, he told me that they've never done that before.
They've never done it for any PBA players, so it was really something special, something they haven't done. Hopefully it's something that they'll think about doing in the future when other great players retire. But I'm really thankful. PBA, Sports 5, TV 5, the fans, everyone that's interacted with me on social media, and the Alaska Aces, thank you very much. Now, again, if you like this video, hit the like button, hit the thumbs up, please subscribe, and hit the bell so you're notified for my future videos. We'll see you tomorrow.
On a shout out to Max, Christian, Seth, Emilio, Alex, and my crush Carly.
Oh!
Whoa! Wait, what?
What? I think you just broke the internet.